Shalom and blessings, my dear friends in Cohiba, Portugal. As this week we read the Parsha Vayeshev, the story of Joseph and his brothers, and we are getting ready for the holiday of Hanukkah, which I would like to read to you, a letter from the Rebbe, penned in 1980. And this is it. The illumination, the obligation to illuminate the world. Hanukkah 5741. By grace of God, on the eve of Hanukkah 5741, 1980, Brooklyn, New York, to all participants of the Hanukkah menorah in the USA, greetings and blessings. Hanukkah, the festival of lights, recalls the victory of more than 2100 years ago, of a military weak but spiritually strong Jewish people, over the mighty forces of a ruthless enemy that have overrun the Holy Land and threatened to engulf the land and the people in its darkness. The miraculous victory culminating in the rededication of the sanctuary in Jerusalem and rekindling the menorah, which had been desecrated and extinguished by the enemy, has been celebrated annually since these 8 days of Hanukkah, especially by lighting the Hanukkah menorah, also as a symbol and a message of triumph, of freedom over oppression, spirit over matter, and light over darkness. It is a timely, reassuring message, for the forces of darkness are ever present. Moreover, the danger does not exist exclusively from the outside. It often lurks close at home. And from its insidious erosion, time-honored values and principles are the foundation of any decent society. Needless to say, darkness is not chased away by brooms and sticks, but by illumination. Our sages said, a little light expels a lot of darkness. The Hanukkah lights remind us in a most obvious way that the illumination begins at home, within oneself, within one's family, by increasing and intensifying the lights of Torah and mitzvahs in our everyday experience. Even as the Hanukkah lights are kindled in a growing number from day to day, but though it begins at home, it does not stop there. Such is the nature of light. When one kindles a light for his own benefit, the benefit is also for those in the vicinity. Indeed, the Hanukkah lights are expressly meant to illuminate the outside, symbolizing and alluding the duty to bring light to those who, for one reason or another, still walk in darkness. This is true of the individual, is true for the nation, especially the great United States under God, generously blessed by God both with material and spiritually riches. It is surely the duty and the privilege of the nation to promote the forces of light both at home and abroad in a steady growing measure. Let us pray that the message of Hanukkah will illuminate everyday life for everyone personally and society at large, and bring brighter life in every respect, both materially and spiritually, with esteemed blessings in the spirit of Hanukkah, signed M. Schneerson, Rabbi M. Schneerson. I'd like to wish everyone in Coimbra a spiritually and physical triumph and victory, and may we see the illumination of the world, and may the war in Ukraine end, and when we have only peace and unity around the world. Shalom and happy Hanukkah, my dear friends. Shalom.